या इमाम ज़मां, या इमाम ज़मां, या इमाम ज़मां, या इमाम
ज़मां। I would like to introduce our next speaker, which is Dr. Zahir Abbas Sayyed. Dr. Zahir Abbas Sayyed, a general medical practitioner and with a clinical experience of 12 years, and also works as a medical officer for an insurance company as a fraudulent expert. And he has also an experience of hospital administration. He loves to play cricket and is very passionate about it. His vision to uplift the community with his expertise and knowledge is utmost. And now with a loud salwat, I would like to call Dr. Zahir Abbas Sayyed to deliver his lecture on the 12 Talks program. And his topic is the belief of Imam Mahdi Ajjalallahu Ta'ala Farajul Sharif in the common belief in all Muslims. Bar Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad salwat.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Surah Bani Israel, verse number 71. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Yawma nab'u kulla unasim bi imamihim. This ayat clearly states that Allah will call every people with the imam. So there are traditions in numerous books and different sects of community or Islam, but this ayat clearly states that on the day of judgment every people will be called with their imam. So it means that having an imam for oneself is obligatory. You should have an imam, as the ayat of Quran clearly states that on the day of judgment you will be called with their imam. So in Muslim community there are 73 sects, in which every group has their different imam. Sunnis have their 4 imams, Shias have 12 imams, and Dawoodis and Ismailis have their own number of imams. So the question is, what is correct and what is true? How many imams should be there? So there are numerous traditions in the books of Muslims. We can prove that there are 12 imams which has to be followed. Muhammad ibn Abdullah Khatib al-Tibrizi mentions in his book Miskatul Masabih. The reporter says, I heard the Apostle of Allah say that the Islam should now cease to be glorious up to 12 caliphs, everyone them from being Quraysh. And the affairs of men will not cease to decline so long as 12 men will rule over them. Muslim Ibn Hajjaj in his book Sahih al-Muslim states that the affairs of the people will continue to conducted as long as they are governed by the 12 caliphs, each of them being from Quraysh. So again and again in their books, in their traditions, it has been mentioned that the Islam will be ruled over by 12 caliphs, which will be from Quraysh. Abu Isa Muhammad ibn al-Tirmizi in his book Sunan al-Tirmizi states that I will be followed by 12 khalifas, all will be Quraysh. From all these above traditions, we can conclude that there will be 12 imams, which majority of Muslims declared that there is no need of imam. The another question arises from the community is, there is no need for guidance, that imam should be there for guidance. So highlighting this aspect, there is an incident, there is a very interesting incident which I would like to narrate over here. One of the companions of Imam Jafar Sadiq alayhi salam, Yunus ibn Yaqub, he said during the season of Hajj, he along with himself other companions were present with Imam. Suddenly Hisham ibn Hakam entered the gatherings and he approached towards Imam. So Imam Jafar Sadiq alayhi salam, he paid utmost respect towards him and he showed respect towards him, he called and sat him nearer to himself. So after seeing all this, the imam felt that some people might feel displeased with this, as he is showing most respect towards him. So then imam, pointing towards Hisham, wholeheartedly said that this young man helps us with his arguments, speech and debates. Then he said, oh Hisham, just tell us the story about Basra, where you had a conversation with Amr ibn Ubayd. So Hisham ibn Hakam said, my tongue has no power to say in front of you and I feel ashamed to say something in your presence. Then Imam said, we desire this from you and you have to obey our commands. So under these circumstances, Hisham ibn Hakam narrated this story of Basra. So it's a very interesting point, and you know how we should start the debate and how we should debate with the others. It has been beautifully narrated over here that Hisham ibn Hakam came to know about Amr ibn Ubayd, that he used to give sermons and give discussions about imamate and wilaya in Basra, in the mosque of Basra. One day he was sitting in the mosque of Basra, and along with his students, and he was discussing about imamat and wilayat. So he used to reject the beliefs of Shia and the followers of Holy Prophet's Ahle Bayt. So Hisham ibn Hakam became very sad to hear about this, and he thought to go to Basra. One day he started his journey to Basra, and he reached on Friday. He directly went to the mosque of Basra, where Amr ibn Ubayd was present there, and number of peoples were surrounding him, and they were asking questions, and he was replying their questions. Hisham ibn Hakam sat in a corner. He faced towards Amr ibn Ubayd and said, "O learned man, I am a stranger. I just came now, and I want to ask some questions. Just allow me to ask some questions to you." He said, "Okay, you can ask." So Hisham ibn Hakam, he said, "Do you have eyes?" So Amr ibn Ubayd said, "What kind of question is this?" So he said, "My question will be like this." So Amr ibn Ubayd said, "You can ask whatever foolish your questions might be." So he said, "I'll ask only if you promise me that you will reply my all questions." He said, "Okay." Then he said, "Do you have eyes?" He said, "Yes." "What do you do with that?" He said, "I see with my eyes, and I can differentiate between the images, pictures and colors." Okay. The next question was, "Do you have a nose?" He said, "Yes." "What do you with that?" So he said, "I smell with my nose." The third question was, "Do you have a tongue?" He said, "Yes." "What do you with that?" So he said, "I speak with the help of my tongue." Similar questions kept on continuing. He said, "Do you have hands?" He said, "Yes." "So what does you do with your hands?" He said, "I lift the objects, I can do hard works, I can sense the things, which is hard or soft." Then the next question was, "Do you have legs?" So he said, "Yes." "What do you do with your legs?" He said, "I can move from one place to another with the help of my legs." And the next one, the most interesting, "Do you have a heart?" He said, "Of course, yes, I have a heart." Hisham ibn Hakam said, "You have all the body parts which are functioning. So what do you do with your heart?" So he said, "I can judge and sense the feelings what other body parts do." So he said, "If all your body parts are working properly, then why do you need a heart?" So Amr ibn Ubayd said, "Suppose if some of the body parts are not doing their actions properly, not doing their acts properly, if they are doing suspicious activities, for example, the sense of smell is not proper. Suppose the vision, the things which he is seeing is not clear. Similarly, the hands which are doing, it is not clear what things we are touching. So in that case, all the body parts will consult a judge. So the judge is heart, which is like a capital of a city. The heart will convey that you are doing this mistakes. This is not proper. The heart will guide you. Okay, this is not proper. This should not be done." Hisham says, Amr ibn Ubayd became silent after hearing this. Now the question is raised among the Muslims that believe in Imam Mahdi alayhi salam has been created by Shias. But I would like to clear over this, that the belief in Imam Mahdi alayhi salam is in the entire book of Muslim Ummah also, it exists. The entire Muslim Ummah believe in one Allah, one Kaaba, one Holy Quran, and the Muslim Ummah also have a common belief that existence of Imam Mahdi alayhi salam. There are numerous hadiths. Few of this I will just like to narrate over here. Al-Bukhari, Abu Huraira narrates from Allah's Messenger, "How will you be when Isa ibn Maryam alayhi salam descends amongst you and your Imam Mahdi is amongst you?" Sahih Muslim, it is narrated from Abu Huraira that Messenger of Allah observed, what will be your state when Isa ibn Maryam alayhi salam descends among you and there will be an Imam Mahdi alayhi salam amongst you? Abu Dawud, the author, records the following tradition in relation to Imam Mahdi alayhi salam. Abdullah ibn Masud narrates that the Holy Prophet said, if one day of this world will remain, that Allah will prolong that day so much that He will send it in a man who belongs to me or to my family. He will fill the earth with equity and justice as it has been filled with oppression and tyranny. And you know, many of the sects, they deny the existence and birth of Imam Mahdi alayhi salam. I would just like to highlight on this, that every Muslim believe that one day Imam Mahdi alayhi salam will come and destroy the evil government. He will establish just government of Allah and fill the earth with justice and tranquility. But few of them deny this. What is the reason behind this for denying the existence and birth of Imam Mahdi alayhi salam? Ibn Hajar al-Makki writes in his book Sawaiq al-Muharrika with respect to Imam Mahdi alayhi salam, Imam Hasan Askari alayhi salam was martyred and he left one son named Abul Qasim Muhammad al-Hujjar, and at that time his age was 5 years and Allah has given him imamat at this tender age. He is also called as Qaim al-Muntazir. It is said that he is in Ghaibat and people don't know where he is living. The moment it is accepted that Imam Mahdi alayhi salam is born, everyone will ask, who is his father? So the answer will be Imam Hasan Askari alayhi salam. Everyone believe that Imam will come and he will just fulfill this earth with justice. So everyone knows that Imam is Barhaq and Imam is appointed by Allah. So the same thing, if they believe that Imam is born and who is his father, Imam Hasan Askari alayhi salam, so then they have to believe, unko ye believe karna padega, that Imam Hasan Askari alayhi salam was an appointed Imam from Allah and he was on truth, वो बरहक थे, एंड उनके अगेंस्ट में जो भी हुकूमत थी, हुक्मरान थे, और जो निज़ाम था वो बातिल था, तो उनको वो मानना पड़ेगा। उसी तरीके से ये सिलसिला ऐसा चलता जाएगा, और फिर जब ये पहले इमाम अली अलैहि सलाम पर आएगा, तब भी उनको ये मानना पड़ेगा कि जो हुक्मरान जो थे और जो निज़ाम था वो बातिल था, क्योंकि इमाम बरहक है और इमाम जो है वो अल्लाह की तरफ से मुंतखब किया गया है। तो उनको ये मानना पड़ेगा कि जो हुक्मरान है और जो निज़ाम था वो बातिल था। जस्ट टू सप्रेस द टिरंट लीडर्स, द मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी दे डिनाई द एग्जिस्टेंस एंड बर्थ ऑफ इमाम मेहदी अलैहिस्सलाम। वस्सलाम, मे अल्लाह हास्टन हिज रीअपीयरेंस।
आरिज़ा इसलिए खाके शिफा से लिखा है, जरूर होगी इनायत इमाम आखिर की।